Okay, Ivy, you've got some troubles with your maybe 8-year-old Galen. I guess you bought him when he was 5 years old, and he wasn't exactly what you were led to believe when you bought him. He seems to be, from what I get from your letter here, he seems to be working good when everything is in more of a controlled situation. I've seen some videos of you loping around in your arena, and shoot, he looks good. I mean, he's loping circles, he looks like he's comfortable, and stopping and turning around and everything fine. But when you get him outside, he seems quite reactive, quite timid to, you know, the world in itself. So that's one of the things I really talk about on the videos that we did at Cowboy Campus about getting your horse prepared for the world outside. When you're flagging your horse, you know, there's what people will do is they'll flag a horse and maybe they'll only get it half done. They'll get them desensitized to a flag to where when they wave that flag around, he'll just get stopped, which is the correct answer for the flag work on them, to desensitize them. But that's only half of the deal. Then what you need to do is you need to sensitize them to a flag to where you can get them to move out. So you've got this horse to where when he gets bothered, it looks like he parks onto the brakes and he says in his mind, nobody moves, nobody gets hurt. And in order to get a horse comfortable about his surroundings, he needs to be able to move his feet. He's a flight animal. They have to feel like they can move their feet, so if things get really bad, they can leap. But in saying that, if you do your flag work correctly, like I go through in the videos, you can have that horse understand that if he looks to you, you can look, you're going to be the alpha leader of your herd of two that you're building. So you would get him to where you desensitize him to the flag, as well as you would sensitize him to the flag, and you could turn it from one to the other quite easily. And what the horse will start understanding is the difference between him being sensitized to the flag, where you might ask him to move off from it, and being desensitized to the flag, where you would ask him to be relaxed and comfortable with your flag. Would be your intent. So what you want to do is you want to build trust in your horse that when something arises that he feels that he's a reactive horse where he has to leave, being that he's a flight animal, that's just normal for him. If he looks to you and you say within your body language and you feel that he needs to stay, that he will read what you're telling him and he will stay. And you get that through proper flag work to where you get him to where you would have him move off the flag and where you could get him to stay with the flag. So that would be the main thing I would do, and just from watching the videos, and I see him handling fairly decently in your round pen when you're riding him around, but you say that when you get outside, things will spook him and he's going to want to stampede and get out of there. I would think you haven't done a proper job of flagging him. And maybe the folks that you sent him to, the trainer that you sent him to, maybe got him half flagged to where he'll park and he'll get stopped when something scares him, but he's not good about it. He's just saying, if I don't move my feet, I'm all right. But what he needs to do, that you've only done half the training on him. You need to have him to where he can understand that he can move out. It's very important to make sure your flag work was correct. So that would be, without seeing that horse in person and without visiting with you on the phone, that would be where I think you're at. You need to do more flag work on him to where he understands he needs to read you. Your flag is just the world around him. He needs to be able to respond to that flag and not so much react to it. And if he read how you're the life in your body that you're presenting him, he would learn that he would be safe if he stayed with you. So if you've got any more questions about that, you give me a call or get a hold of me at Cowboy Campus and we can visit more about it. But not seeing the horse, I would say that's probably a good place to start.